Hi, this video is exclusively for my patients who had joined my diabetes residential tour or diabetes virtual tour, especially the patients who are not able to control the blood sugar, their blood glucose, in spite of following the recommended DIP diet. So if you are the one who are still having a very high blood glucose level, in spite of following all my instruction, then you have to watch this video very, very carefully. When I say high blood sugar, I mean a blood sugar level more than 250 mg per deciliter or more than 13.9 millimole per liter. If you are able to maintain your blood sugar less than 250 mg per deciliter or less than 13.9 millimole per liter, then it is a normal blood sugar, it is a healthy blood sugar. But in spite of following the DIP diet, if still you are having a blood sugar more than 250 mg per deciliter or more than 13.9 millimole per liter, then you have to watch this video carefully. I divide this video in two parts. Part one, for those who are not on insulin, whom I did not recommend insulin. And part two is, of course, for those who are still needed to take some insulin, whom I have recommended insulin. First, I'll start with those who are not on insulin, who are not on medication, but they are just following the diet and still they have a high blood glucose level. Now, suppose I have recommended you out of the four type of diet you are already familiar with: tortoise type diet, rabbit type diet, frog type DIP diet and golden frog type DIP diet. Let's say I have already put you on a frog type DIP diet and you are following the diet as per my advice, but your average blood sugar, when I say average blood sugar level, you may be remembering during the diabetes tour, I have explained you average blood sugar means you check the fasting blood sugar, you check the blood sugar before going to sleep, assuming that the last meal you had is at least 2 hours before going to sleep, the last blood sugar, add both the blood sugar, fasting and the blood sugar just going to before sleep, add both of them, divide by 2, and the number which you get, you can call it average blood sugar. If you are on frog diet, let's say I recommended you to be on frog diet, you are taking frog diet, and I asked you also that every 15 days you have to check your average blood sugar. If you are checking the average blood sugar and if it is coming more than 250 mg per deciliter, this means that either you are not following the frog diet properly, you may be doing a little bit of cheating, you may be deviating from the rules as I explained, or you may be strictly following the frog diet and still the blood sugar is higher than 250 mg per deciliter. This means the frog diet is not suitable for you. It is not working as expected. So what you have to do? Remember the chart I gave you, the DIP maintenance diet chart. So as you can see on the screen, you have to follow the red and green arrow. Red arrow means you have to take which is pointing towards towards downwards. This means instead of frog diet, you must take the golden frog diet. Red arrow is for those whose blood sugar is more than 250 mg per deciliter. So this means if your blood sugar is higher than 250 mg per deciliter, the answer is very simple, that this diet is not suitable, the present DIP diet. You have to shift downwards. Instead of frog diet, you have to take golden frog diet. Those who are on rabbit diet already and still their blood sugar is higher, this means instead of rabbit diet, for some days you have to follow the frog diet. You have to keep on shifting down. If you are not able to manage your blood sugar less than 250 mg per deciliter. Now let's say you are already in golden frog diet and you are following it very, very strictly, and even then your average blood sugar is more than 250. This means this golden frog diet is also not doing its work properly as expected, and it means with the diet you may be needing a little bit of medication. For that you may contact your nearest doctor or you can contact me. I can help you guide, but I can tell you, even if you reduce your blood sugar by taking a little bit of medicine, but that is going to give you a satisfactory blood sugar number which will give you a feeling that everything is good, but in reality medicine can give you a good number but not good health. So but as of now, in this present situation, in this world, These are the only solution that first you stick to the diet as much as you can, but still it is high, the blood sugar is high, then take the support of medicine a little bit. So, and that is how it is. This means humanly you did your best by sticking to the diet, the best known diet which can control the blood sugar, that is Golden Frog diet. And if it is not happening in spite of that, or if you are not able to maintain that diet properly, this means you have to take little bit support of medication, that's all. Now this is a part for those who are on no insulin. Now the second part is for insulin dependent patient. Now here is the three steps. This is video is for insulin dependent patient who are on already on Golden Frog diet and also taking the little bit of insulin as I recommended you during the time when you have joined my virtual tour or residential tour. So here you have to follow three step protocol. Step one is very simple. Along with taking the Golden Frog diet, as strictly as possible, you take the recommended dose of insulin. When I say recommended dose of insulin, it means either, number one, the amount of insulin which I recommended while you were going through the 3 days of tour, or the amount of insulin which currently you are taking. Whichever is higher, you take that amount of insulin. So along with Golden Frog diet, you are taking insulin, and now if the average blood sugar is coming more than 250 mg per deciliter, this means this diet and insulin together is not helping you to achieve the goal, achieve the normal blood sugar level. So what to do? Very simple. Step 2, go to the step 2. As you can see on the screen, find your average blood sugar, which is very easy. Fasting blood sugar plus the blood sugar before going to sleep divided by 2. And see what is the number, how much higher. If the average blood sugar is between 250 mg per deciliter to 300 mg per deciliter, that is 16.6 millimole per liter, if it is in between that, this means the insulin amount the next day you have to increase by 10%. Instead of taking, let's say I recommended you 10 units of insulin, from tomorrow you will take 11 units of insulin, and tomorrow also you will check the average blood sugar, that is fasting blood sugar and the blood sugar before going to sleep, and see how much is the number. If it is still not less than 250, if it is still between 250 and 300, this means even 11 is not suitable for you. You have to increase the insulin dose by 10%, approximately 10%. This means instead of 11 unit of insulin, 11 unit of, for example, I recommended you 10 unit of insulin. This means instead of 11, you have to increase it by 10%. Instead of 11, you can take 12 unit. So here, as you can see on the screen, you have to taper down or you have to increase the insulin dose based on the reference, as you can see on the screen. And the reference is very simple. If you are able to maintain a blood sugar between 150 mg per deciliter, that is 8.3 millimole per liter, to 250 mg per deciliter, then this is the optimum range. This means the amount of insulin which you took was perfect. And this means next day also you have to take the same amount. But if the average blood sugar is between 250 to 300, this means it is on a higher side. This means the amount of insulin which you have took today, tomorrow you have to increase it by 10%. Let's say today you took about 10 units of Lantus and 10 units of Actrapid. So tomorrow you have to increase both of them by 10%. That means instead of taking 10 units of Lantus, you have to take 11 units of Lantus. Instead of taking 10 units of Actrapid, you are taking 11 units of Actrapid. So this kind of modification, this kind of adjustment you have to do on a daily basis. This means every day you have to check the average blood sugar. And let's say today's average blood sugar, which you will be able to check only by night, because in the morning you took the fasting blood sugar and at night you took the blood sugar before going to sleep, and you added them divided by 2, and let's say it came more than 300 mg per deciliter. This means more than 16.6 millimole per liter. So as you can see on step 3, as you can see on the screen, you have to increase the insulin dose by 20%. This means instead of taking 10 units of Lantus, you are taking 12 units. So whatever is the present insulin which you took today, you have to increase tomorrow when you take by 20% because your blood sugar was more than 300. Similarly, let's say a particular day you checked your average blood sugar and it came less than 150 mg per deciliter or less than 8.3 millimole per liter. This means today the amount of insulin which you took was more than required. So tomorrow when you decide to inject insulin, you have to reduce the dosage by 10%. So as you can see on the screen, the scale, how to taper down, how to increase or decrease or adjust the insulin is very clearly you can see. So by choosing this formula, by sticking to this rule, you will never land up in a very, very high blood sugar, right? So always you have to keep on increasing and decreasing the insulin dosage based on your previous day's average blood sugar. Here the important point is you have to keep on sticking to the golden frog diet. And sometime in case of infection, in case of fever, viral fever, etc., or in case not able to follow the golden frog diet, in case of any outing, you may not be able to control or get the good outcome, good blood sugar level. In those days, it is even more important to check the average blood sugar, and based on your average blood sugar, you are able to decide what will be the approximate insulin dose for tomorrow. So by following this protocol, you can protect yourself from getting into a very, very high blood sugar or a very, very low blood sugar. You must remember that diabetes, high blood sugar may be bad, but low blood sugar is worse. So to escape from the danger of very low blood sugar and to escape from the danger of very high blood sugar, this protocol is something which can keep your blood sugar within range. This means you have two tools with you. One is the food to control your blood sugar, and other is supporting temporary, for a temporary period, is the insulin amount. So if you to know how much to adjust both of them, the best thing is every day you take the average blood sugar, and once you are able to do it, at least you will not fall into the emergency situation of very, very high blood sugar or very, very low blood sugar. So I recommend you to watch this video at least 2-3 times so that you are very clear about it, that how to take insulin. Taking insulin and calculating a correct dose of insulin is also a science and art as well. So you watch this video carefully once again so that you are clear in your mind what you have to do. So, and the reference point is average blood sugar, number one, and number two reference point is your HbA1c. So after following this protocol, every 3 months you have to check your HbA1c, and if you are able to manage your HbA1c less than 8.4, then this means you have managed well. But if your HbA1c crosses 8.4%, this means still your blood sugar was on a higher side. So you have to think of either following the golden frog diet very, very strictly. Maybe you were deviating. Maybe you were doing some cheating. So you were not following the recommendation of DIP diet properly. Or maybe because of infection, fever, or sometime bad weather condition, very, very cold, blood sugar was fluctuating too much. So this means you have to decide to increase the insulin dosage. And whenever you are increasing the insulin dosage, if you are the one who are on both kind of insulin, fast acting and long acting, first prefer to increase the long acting. Fast acting is, which gives an immediate impact on blood sugar level, is also very dangerous and harmful for the body. So always I avoid giving or recommending the fast acting. Only in case, just by giving long acting, if the patient is unable to control the blood sugar, then only for a brief period I ask them to take a short acting. Otherwise, first rely only on the diet. If not, then take little bit of long acting. If not, then for a temporary measure, short acting with lot of care. So I hope this video will help you clear the doubt on how not to fall into very, very high blood sugar or very, very low blood sugar emergency situation. If you have any question, feel free to ask me. This is Dr. Bishwaroop Roy Chowdhury. All the best. Thank you.